I'm George Shull. I came here to the Carnegie Station for experimental evolution because I was interested in doing field experiments that would lend support to Mr. Darwin's ideas of evolution. I also wanted to apply Mr. Mendel's analysis of how traits are carried from one generation to the next. Now, farmers have been directing the evolution of maize for thousands of years, selecting the best seed to plant in their fields. However, yield still varies greatly from plant to plant and even cob to cob. This is because corn is open pollinated. Each plant is randomly fertilized by pollen carried by the wind. So a cornfield is really a complex mixture of hybrids produced from numerous elementary components. I set about to find a way to reproducibly make high-yielding hybrids. I reasoned that inbreeding would reduce each strain of corn to its elementary components. And then I could control the characteristics of hybrids by crossing two inbred lines. Now first, I developed pure inbred lines by self-fertilizing a corn plant against itself for a number of generations. As had others before me, I found that all of the inbred lines deteriorate as detrimental traits are reduced to a homozygous condition. The inbred plants are smaller and have fewer and smaller cobs with fewer rows and kernels. They're also more susceptible to corn smut and some seeds fail to grow. Now, these are two of my inbred lines. However, the elementary components of the inbred lines are revealed by cross-fertilization, and the hybrid offspring produces 30% more kernels by weight than either inbred parent. The purebred plant maximizes beneficial heterozygous traits, a condition I call heterosis and that others call hybrid vigor. Currently, farmers attempt to improve yield by planting seed from the most vigorous heterozygous plants. But according to Mendel's laws, we expect that the cross of heterozygous parents will produce not only heterozygous offspring that are highly productive, but also homozygous offspring that produce little. Now, crossing inbred lines ensures a uniform population of high-yielding heterozygous plants. I am certain that corn yield could be substantially improved if plant breeders adopted my pure line method to produce hybrid seed.